Good morning, students. Once again, I am Pramod sir. Welcome to you all in Math period, 7th standard Math period. So, students, in first lesson, integers, we have seen properties of addition in our earlier period. Okay, students. Now, in this period, we are going to deal with properties of subtraction of integers. So, students, like addition, in properties of subtraction, first property is closure property. So students, in closure property, if I have taken an example, minus 3, minus and another integer 7. Okay, minus 3 and 7 are integers and now their subtraction. So students, what will be the answer? The answer of minus 3 minus 7 is minus 10. You know it, students. Minus 3 minus into plus minus, that means minus 3 minus 7 minus 10. Now students, here minus 3 is integer, 7 is also integer and their subtraction is also integer. That means more students, if A and B are integers, if A and B are integers, then A minus B equals to C, where C is also integer. Here C is also integer. That means for students, the closure property holds under subtraction. Okay, students. So, in addition, like addition also, the subtraction property under closure it holds. Now, students, the second one, commutative property. Commutative. In earlier class, I told you that commutation means A to B and B to A. Like that, for subtraction, if we will take the same example, let us see. I have taken one integer, another integer, and you know the subtraction, minus 3, minus 7 means minus 10, we know it. And now students, in this example, what we have done? Minus 3, minus 7. Now, exchanging the integers. Now, I am writing 7 first. Of course, we have to do the subtraction and later on minus 3. So, students, here you can see minus into minus becomes plus. And of course, 3, 7 plus 3, 10. Now students, if we check these two results, we come to know that these are not equals. These two are not equals. That means we can say surely that if A and B are integers similarly, then if we subtract B from A, the result will not equal to B minus A. That means these two are not equal. So in this particular case, student, what can we say that the property, the commutative property, subtraction is not. The subtraction is not a commutative for integers. That means, under the properties for integers, the subtraction property of subtraction subtraction is not commutative for integers because these two subtractions are not equal. Now students, the third one we know it, associative. Similarly students, if we take example like this, then automatically what we come to know that if A, B and C are integers, then we know students that A minus B minus C and minus C separate in associative property. Now suppose I will separate A minus B minus C. We have seen students that these will all will not equals like this. A is not equals to B, is not equals to B minus A. Similarly, by taking such example, we will conclude very easily that A minus B minus C will not be equals to A minus B minus C. So students, once again, what can we say that the subtraction integers are not associative under subtraction. So what can we say? Integers are not associative under subtraction. So students, let us see. First forward, I am taking properties of under addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction, we have seen three properties up till now. Which one? The closure property, students, right? For commutative property also. And later on, associative property. And what we come to know, students, under addition, closure property holds. We have seen A plus B equals to C. A is integer, B is integer, then their addition is also integer, so it holds. Regarding commutative property, students, we know A plus B is equal to B plus A. That means the exchanging of the integers does not affect on the result under addition. So it also holds, right? Now for association, what we have seen under addition, that A in bracket, A plus in bracket B plus C equals to A plus B and plus C. So for under addition, for associative property, integers the property holds under addition. Okay. But now we have seen that closure property, okay, it holds, right? Their subtraction and C is also integer. But here in both the cases, under subtraction, these two properties, commutative property and associative property, does not hold. So students, you should know these things properly. You can tabulate it in your notebook also. Okay. You can note it down. Okay. Now students, moving further. Property of zero. Now students, if I subtract zero from any integer, I am saying any integer, then the result will be the integer itself, you know it. That means what? If A is integer And if I am subtracting 0 from it, then what will be the result? Of course, definitely the result will be same as it is. Okay, that is the property of 0. Now students, this topic, property of 1. Now students, listen carefully. I am drawing a number line. You know the number line very well. On equal distance, I am taking the numbers. You know students, let us check for addition first. What happens? If I am taking minus 2, okay students, what I have taken? Minus 2. Now just add 1. What we added now? 1. Now students, minus 2, now we are adding 1, means right side, addition 1, when we add, so we move right hand, right? So students, here 1. So what will be the result? Agar 1, idhar agar le to, minus 1. The result is minus 1. With the help of properties of addition also, you can see minus 2 plus 1 will minus 1. Now students, what is it? What are these numbers? So students, minus 1 humko mil gaya, minus 2 mein add karne se 1 ko humne add kiya. Now what is this? Isko hum kya kahenge? Students, it is the successor. Here minus 1 is successor of minus 2. Minus 2 ka successor kaun hai? Minus 1. That is the property of 1. Yani adding 1 agar hum karte hai to hume successor milta hai. Let us take another example students also. We can take another example. Let us see. Suppose I have taken 2. Okay. And once again, I am adding 1. So what will be the successor of 2? The successor of 2 will be definitely 3. So students, here 3 is the successor of 2. I hope you understood this concept. By adding 1, we get the successor of the given number actually, right? Agar humko 2 diya hai, toh of course definitely the successor will be 3. If 0 will be there, then the successor will be 1. So students, now moving forward, let us see. Now, we have just added, right now? Now, I am subtracting 1, minus 2, okay, I am taking the same number earlier. Now, I am subtracting 1, here I added 1, now here I am subtracting 1. Subtraction gives left hand side, right, like addition gives us right hand side. Now students, minus 2, subtraction is there, so go one place. So what will be the result? Students, you can see here minus 3. Okay. So, minus 2 ke pehle kon aata hai? Agar aisa sawal puchha, the answer will be minus 3. So, pehle kon ke liye hum, pehle ke liye hum kya bolte hain English mein? Dekhiye students, in mathematics we use the word here minus 3 is the predecessor. उसको हम predecessor बोलते हैं students. उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं students? Predecessor. यानी पहले का. Okay students, I hope you understood this thing. Here here minus 3 is the predecessor, minus 2 के P, यानी कब पहले का, minus 3 is the predecessor of minus 2. Now students, I am asking you the same question. Which number is the predecessor of 0? Predecessor, which integer is the predecessor of 0? Of course, you will answer minus 1. So let us write in that format then. Now students, I just told you, second example of this subtraction, what I told you, 0, I am taking, means I have taken 0 as the integer, now I am subtracting 1 like this, so the result will be minus 1, the result will be minus 1. So what will happen, here minus 1 is the predecessor of 0. You understood student now? If I will draw a line and if I ask you the questions, I hope you will answer. If I will ask you that which number is predecessor of 3? Predecessor of 3 means subtraction. Predecessor kitna hai? 2. How will we get 3 minus 1? Okay. And successor of 3 plus 1. Successor of 3 means plus 1. 3 plus 1, 4. You can see. 4 is the successor and 2 is the predecessor of 3. So students, try to do more practice regarding this successor and predecessor. Now students, we can start our second exercise, that is exercise 1B of the lesson. Now students, here let us see the question. Use commutative and associative. Yes students, we have seen property of addition. So students, earlier I told you that A plus B equals to B plus A, it is commutative, and associative, A plus in bracket B plus C equals to in bracket A plus B plus C. So we have to use that property of addition, means commutative and associative, both the properties, to simplify. Now students, I am taking only two examples here. Let us see. This is our question. I am writing my first step. 43 plus 21 plus 79. So students, you know that we have to group. Grouping karna hai. We have to group them, right? To group kaun se bhi kar sakte, ye bhi do, ye bhi do, ye bhi do. But students, if we observe these numbers very seriously, carefully, then what we come to know? 21 and 79. Of course, we will get 100. 71 plus 79, we will get 100. So students, we are going to group these two numbers and we will leave this separate. 43 plus 21 plus 79. So students, it will be 43 plus, of course, it is 100. So the answer is 143. Isn't it very simple? Because we use here associative property for simplifying the question. Here also, the first step will be the question itself. I have written the question now. Now let us see students. 6436. Right. One rule, 64, 36, 100. Very good. And 26, 74. Another good students, that means we can group such numbers that it will be helpful for us in addition. So students, here what I am going to do, 64 plus 36 plus, and another group students, 26 plus 74. So students, we get 100 for the first root, 64 plus 36, 100. And for the another group also, 26 plus 74, ultimately it gives us 100 once again, and 100 plus 100, so it becomes 200. So students, I hope you understood this question and the importance of the properties. Okay? So moving forward students, let us see, fill in the boxes. I have written some examples from the textbook. Look here. C, minus 4 plus minus 5 equals to blank plus minus 4. So here minus 4, here minus 4. Minus 5 remains. Students, it's very easy. We have seen this property. Commutative property, right? Under addition. So a plus b equals to b plus a, it holds. Right? No difference is there in the result actually. So students, we can see here a plus b equals to b means minus 5 plus a. So students, we can write very easily here minus 5. Now students, minus 7 plus minus 8 equals to blank plus minus 7. Minus 7 is there. Now, what we have to write here? Minus 8. Here, L plus blank equals to M plus L. Now, here students, L is there. So, definitely it will be M here. So, students, I hope the fill in the boxes questions are very very easy for you. Now students, verify is the question and I am taking the question B here. So students, what does it mean verify? Verify karna hai students. Iska matlab students, humko check karna hai. Yahan par ek left hand side mein ek statement diya hai and right hand side mein ek statement diya hai. So left hand side equals to right hand side, हमको क्या करना है? Verify करना है. क्या करना है? Verify. So students, what we need for that? So students, first of all, we have to find out the value of LHS. Later on, the value of RHS. If these two values are equal, then LHS will be equals to RHS, isn't it? अगर दोनों का equal दिखाना LHS and RHS, that means what? We have to find the separate value. So let us start, students. So the first step of answer will be this LHS, 19 plus. Now bracket is given. Minus 3 plus 9. Let us solve this first. I am going to solve LHS first. I want to check, I want to find the value of LHS. So 19 as it is, we know it. In bracket now, minus 3 plus 9. So students, we know minus 3 plus 9 means plus 6. We know it. Right? So 19 plus 6, 20. That means I found the value of LHS now. Now I will try for the RHS. In bracket, 19 plus minus 3 plus 9 is equal. Let us check. We are going to solve the bracket first. Plus into minus minus. So 19 minus 3. So of course students, it will be 16 plus 9 is equal to 16 plus 9. Now these two values are same. I told you the step already. Now these two values are same and therefore I can say definitely that 19 plus in bracket bracket minus 3 plus 9. These two are equal. That means we verify this. We verify left hand side and right hand sides. The values are same. We found the value separately and we conclude that it's verified already. Now students, the next question is, prove that the following statements are false. हमको false दिखाना है. Prove that the following statements are false and give reason. सबसे पहली चीज ये false है ये हमको दिखाना है and give reason. We have to mention the result as well. So students, I have chosen two examples here, the C first and later on F we are going to solve. So students, here also the stepping is very very easy. These two are not equal. Actually we have to prove that this statement is false. So let us try. Once again we are going to start with left hand side value. So I am writing the left hand side first. 742 minus 58 minus 10 equals to. Let us see. 742 minus 58. Let us do this. Minus 58, right? 684 students. So 684 minus 10. So it will give us 674. कितना मिलेगा students? The final result 674. Now students, we are going to check right hand side. 742 minus in bracket 58 minus 10 equals to 742 minus 58 minus 10, of course 48. कितना होगा स्टूडेंट 58 माइनस 10 48 ये माइनस ये है ओके सो 742 माइनस 48 सो इफ वी विल डू दिस 742 माइनस 48 सो स्टूडेंट व्हाट विल वी गेट 694 नाउ स्टूडेंट्स लेट अस चेक दिस वैल्यूज दीज आर डिफरेंट 674 is not equals to 694. Therefore, these LHS, I am writing the LHS, these LHS is not equals to these LHS. दोनों के वैल्यू सेम नहीं है. 674 is not equal to 694 and therefore the statement is false. This is the given statement. यहाँ पर इन्होंने equal दिखाया है, मगर equal आता है क्या students? No. These two, the values of these two are not equal. So the statement is false. Students, you have to write in this step only because mathematically, all the steps are very easy as well as very good. So students, you have to follow these steps. Now, the next one, it's very very simple students. 346 minus 276. So this is the larger number, larger minus smaller. So 346 minus 276 a plus minus. So what will be the answer? Let us see. So students, 70 will be answer plus 70. Of course, you can write or if you will not, no matter. And right hand side 276 minus 346. Now students, the difference is there. The larger, the absolute value of this is larger. So the sign which we get is here. 276 plus and this is minus 346. तो सब्ट्रैक्शन तो हम करेंगे फ्रॉम लार्जर नंबर टू स्मॉलर नंबर, बट द साइन विल ऑफ द लार्जर एब्सोल्यूट वैल्यू, सो इट विल बी माइनस 70. सो वंस अगेन स्टूडेंट्स, दीज वैल्यूज आर नॉट सेम. 70 इज नॉट इक्वल्स टू माइनस 70, एंड देयरफॉर व्हाट कैन आई राइट, 346 माइनस 276 is not equals to 276 minus 346, and therefore the statement is false. See the statement here, we have false. So students, I hope you understood this properly, and I am expecting that you will solve the remaining questions as homework. And please send me your writing work on my personal number. Okay, students? See you. Bye-bye.